right now, Tucson Democrats are staging a political rally outside the office of Republican congressional candidate Martha McSally. They're asking McSally to say whether or not she supports conservative Congressman Paul Ryan's new federal budget plan passed by the U.S. House of Representatives today. All of Arizona's Republican representatives in the House voted for the Ryan plan, while Representative Ann Kirkpatrick, along with Congressman Ron Barber and Raul Grijalva, voted against the controversial budget. The biggest reason this proposal is stirring backlash from Democrats is that it would deeply cut spending on so-called entitlement programs, including what's probably the most popular one of all, Medicare. News 4 Tucson's Steve Handelsman has both sides of the debate from Capitol Hill.
It's huge. Medicare costs about $200 billion a year, 15% of the federal budget, and that's going up. Everyone agrees seniors need Medicare, but...
But nobody disagrees that this program is going to bankrupt us if we don't do something about it.
What to do is what the battle's about. The House today passed a plan to cut $5 trillion in spending over 10 years on Medicare and Medicaid for the poor, Obamacare, and education, Republican Paul Ryan's plan.
We owe the country an alternative, one that actually grows the economy, one that balances the budget and pays off the debt, one that secures retirement, not with empty promises, but real reforms.
Every House Democrat voted against the Medicare and the other cuts.
Is that a statement of our values to say to our seniors, you are on your own? You are on your own? I don't think so.
Democrats say hike taxes on the rich and on oil companies instead of cutting Medicare. Republicans refuse.
And because they say hands off the most powerful and the most privileged, their budget has to come after everybody else, and it does.
Awful, evil, terrible.
Old arguments, says Ryan.
If taxing, borrowing, and spending was working, we would know by now. It's not.
But which plan will work to win votes?
That's what this is really about, the November elections, because this year, Medicare cuts will go nowhere in the democratically controlled Senate. I'm Steve Handelsman, NBC News, Capitol Hill.